Hey, Grim, is it true ducks fly upside down here because there's nothing worth crapping on?
Moving on. Today's matchup is going to be complete mayhem. The teams are taking the field. The Orcs of Hazzard battle the Leveland Burns. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's time to turn on, tune in, and get your mutant buzz on. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here. It's NFL game day, and you know what that means.
Yeah, the town will be in flames tonight, and half the city's population will be sliding down greased street poles and eating all-you-can-eat horseshit buffets from the curb.
Yes, victory can be bittersweet sometimes, Bricks. Let's see if the home team can light up this town like a Roman candle. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
You know, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot. A great throw and a great catch, but sadly to the wrong. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and 10. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
He took a beast boost injection. Now watch him stomp all over his opponents.
I want to take a beast boost.
Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey.
Hey, man, I was hanging on the kettle now. You know what happened?
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and 10. And the defense goes for the jugular. And the QB has to try to run out of bounds before they get to him. Needless to say, with seven crazed defenders coming after him, that's not easy.
Ah, the old quarterback shellac play.
And it's first and 10. A big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10. trick. Anything he could do. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down. And he is on fuego.
Yeah, he must have just eaten some of those death wings they serve on the concourse. They'll blow your ass apart. And they line up for the extra point. It's good. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and 10. Whoa, and he laterals the ball to the player behind him. Just some good old downhill running there as he picks up the first down. And it's first and 10. Like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. Second down and 10.
Ah, another interception. Geez, you give this guy a bigger paycheck than everybody else comes.
Oh, with the brain scrambler.
Is that right, Quinn? That penalty makes no sense.
And something ain't kosher here, and I'm not talking about the corned beef with extra mayo. Second down, the side. Defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. And it's first and 10. Defense calls more speed. Man, that defender just turned on his jets. Boom to the moon. Another loser bites the dust. In the NFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
And that'll be second down and 4. Oh, great play by the defense. The receiver didn't stand a chance. Third and 4. First down and 7. And he runs it in for the touchdown. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Oh, he just got crushed. And it's first and 10. And the defense gets another pick. Man, what a hit that was. And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. And it's first and 10.
What is this, 80s wrestling?
Second down and 5. They go to the ground game and pick up the first with the vicious kill.
Did you know late hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schwong Galaxy phone.
And it's first and 10. Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. See a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. And it's first and 10. A 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. My parole officer.
Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. And the offense has only 2 running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last 2 runners for this outfit.
And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. Third down and, well, good luck. Yeah, And that's a sack.
Speaking of sacks, has anybody seen my powder? I'm itching like crazy over here.
Oh, my God, can't fit it. And then I can get covered up. Come on, son.
Quarter one comes to an end. If they don't get it together, this game is going to turn into a rout. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and ten. Picks up maybe a deuce at most. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the NFL. And that'll be second and eight to go. For a yard. Third down and six. Oh, holy smokes! He just killed that player with a cheap shot! That's why we love the NFL! Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he put all of his foot into that one. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy of 3 returns. Oh, man, he just...
Bingo, bingo, I just hit that mutant bingo. And all I was missing was his number for the last 3 plays. Talk about luck.
And it's first and ten. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit then?
I know I said never hit a man when he's down. It's just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
First down and one. And that player just transformed into the end zone with a burst of speed.
I think he's more of a downers guy than a speed freak, friend. He's running from his demons, it's clear.
You know, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and ten. About a 3-yard pickup.
Oh man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. Second down and seven. And they run it for a couple of yards. Third down and five. And he shuffled his feet so well on that play, he should go to lost wages and deal cards. First down! And it's first and 10. And he just slipped. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. And he scores! Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one. And it's first and 10. Oh, what a sack there. I heard this guy likes to play with soft balls. He's going to play with crushed balls from here on out. Second down and long. Wow, the quarterback just threw a sonic. He broke free and has open field in front of him. Second down and 10. Caught for the first down. And it's first and 10. Crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
Second down in a very lot. The defender says, I don't think so. Third down, and the punter is warming up. Boom! Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome! I hope they have raincoats in the front row, because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and 10. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
Man, what a hit that was. And it's first and 10. Man, guys like a freight train. Nice pickup there for a first down. And it's first and 10. Too many players that kids can look up to at home. I'm glad one guy, and he fumbles it, Bricks. That was a screwed up play if I ever saw one. Oh, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. And it's first and 10. Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first time out.
Yeah, for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
And the offense goes into their two-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Bricks' match.
He is fighting for every yard. Defense gives up 5 yards on that pass play. And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. And that's another turnover for the defense. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely the tackle wasn't home.
This one did this a better than some time.
And it's first and 10. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. The defense lost another linebacker on that play, and only 2 remain on the roster. Their defense is getting very close to forfeiting this game. Second down and 5. Opens up for them and allows the... Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Yeah. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass.
Yeah, well, at least they don't have to forfeit, Grim.
That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Well, the third quarter coming up. Bricks, this game has been a hot mess so far.
Yeah, kind of like the morning after eating hot chicken wings. It's a hot mess on the exit ramp, if you know what I mean.
Okay, I can't.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! See that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and 10.
Oh, man.
And like Bricks' balls, he is loose and It's first and 10. And the defense gets another pick. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
And that's a run for no gain. Second and 3. And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
Third down and 3. And the defense just knocked the wind out of that quarterback. Most kickers should be able to make this one.
But will this kicker make it? Find out next time on NFL Game Day.
Straight through the uprights. The defense is down to their last linebacker. He's going to have to suck it up and not die out there.
They can bribe the refs in this game. Why not bribe the Grim Reaper?
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so are the fans. And it's first and 10. And they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down and forever. Look out, that's an all-out attack on the QB. And in some leagues, you aren't even allowed to touch the QB. In the NFL, they have plays just for killing them. That's what I'm talking about. And it's first and 10. I'm running out of excuses for this QB. And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
And that big fella looks and dances just like my mother-in-law.
Maybe it is your mother-in-law, if I'm not mistaken.
You know what? You're right.
And here comes the extra point attempt. Straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Oh, hold everything. Looks like there's a penalty on the play. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. And with another pick. And Matt Mutin just about met his maker on that hit.
I thought he was made in China.
I don't see any Chinese guys down there.
You're a fucking moron.
And it's first and 10.
It certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and 10. At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than complete. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Nah, still working on my salami here, Bricks. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. And it's first and 10. Nice hit. And it's first and 10. He had nowhere to go and got nothing out of it. Second down and 10. Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. Touchdown. And he rumbles that one into the end zone. Nicely done.
I can't run like that unless it's Cooper night at Taco Hell. He has better footwork though than me on account of not clenching his cheeks, though.
The Cleveland Burns got their asses kicked and handed to them today and lose by forfeit. It's probably a good thing the game ended up in forfeit. They weren't going to make it out of the stadium alive with this performance anyway. The fans were going to kill them if the opposition didn't.
Gotta love that fan passion.
Let's hear what the game's MVP has to say about this carnage.
I'd rather listen to Sarah Palin read the entire works of Shakespeare while tripping my brains out.
Actually, that sounds kind of fun.
Grim Blitzro with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you...